That crashing sound you've been hearing is the sound of big box bookstores tumbling down. In San Francisco alone, Barnes & Noble checked out, with Borders right behind. But what does their demise mean for the survival of independent bookshops?
Independent stores in general, there's some opportunity out there to try to win those customers.
Pete Mulvihill of San Francisco's iconic Green Apple bookstore isn't about to dance on any store's grave, big or small, but he isn't crying either.
We weren't huge fans of their aggressive expansion, and they knocked a lot of independent stores out of business. That says we're still here, as are, you know, I think 40 bookstores in San Francisco and 200, 250 in Northern California.
But a number of independents didn't make it. Websites like Amazon and the rise of e-readers have pushed many booksellers off the shelf. Still, Mulvihill is optimistic.
People are surviving. We still have 500 people walk in the store, in the doors every day, even though they can find some of the things online cheaper.
Green Apple customer Susie Whips says the closing of the book chains means she's even more likely to shop locally.
I think it's just even more important to come to these smaller bookstores, because I think supporting good literature that's actually on a page that you can dog ear and read in bed is more important.
The same economic turmoil that hit bookstores has meant a big rise in usage at public libraries like San Francisco's. But just like small bookstores, they're adapting to changing readership habits.
So all the different formats that materials come in today is something that libraries have to try to provide as well, so everybody can get access to the same materials.
There's a QR code.
Mulvihill is also taking on the electronic book revolution head on. Now his in-store customers can use smartphones to buy Google e-books from his online shop.
I think people, especially in the Bay Area, realize that if they don't shop at their mom and pop stores, be it a hardware store, a bookstore, or anywhere else, they're going to disappear.
Joe Rosato, Jr., NBC News.